Hello everybody, in this lecture I will be discussing with you about what is small signal and small signal operation. I have already discussed with you in one of my last lectures about what is small signal. Small signal means the signal, the alternating signal which is having not much high amplitude swing in the positive or negative half cycle. So with that alternating signal, how the transistor will work, that will be giving us the small signal operation. So let us first look at this IV characteristics. Let us plot the input characteristics for a particular transistor, suppose VB versus IE. If we plot, this is the IV characteristics for base emitter diode, BE diode. And you know the PN junction, for any PN junction diode, the characteristic curve will be an exponential, will be of exponential nature. It is like this. So you can see that if this is the Q point, now based on this Q point, if we mark the two voltages, that is one for VB and one voltage and one current, one for VB and another for IE. So this is the graph. When an AC voltage is coupled into the base of a transistor, that means AC voltage is coupled to the base of a transistor, that means we are giving an alternating signal as the input to the base of a transistor, and AC voltage appears across the base emitter diode, and the voltage accordingly is appearing across the base emitter diode. Now this is the, suppose, instantaneous operating point when the voltage increases to its positive peak. So suppose take a point based on, take an interpolated line based on Q, and suppose at any other position the Q will move up to a higher position, and in other time it will move up to a lower position. So this is a QH suppose, and this is QL. So Q is moving all along this as per the alteration of the input signal. So based on this QH we will be interpolating, and based on this QL we will be interpolating. So three lines will be, we will be having. So the instantaneous operating point, which is Q, it is moving to the upper point, and then on the other hand, when the sine wave decreases to its negative peak, it will move to the instantaneous operating point will move to the lower point. So if we now draw the particular alternating waveform based on this interpolated lines, so we will be seen that it will be of such a nature. That means it is also of alternating nature. So the total base emitter voltage is an AC voltage. So this is nothing but AC emitter, AC voltage. This is total VBE, and this you can see it is alternating in nature, as because we have applied AC signal at the over and above with the DC base emitter voltage, and that DC base emitter voltage was used for forward biasing the base emitter junction. And with that, the alternating signal which is applied as the input is has been added, and hence this alternating nature of the VBE will come. So the size of the AC voltage and the size of the applied AC voltage will determine how far the instantaneous point will move away from the Q point. That means the position of QH or QL will depend on how far the input signal which is being applied at the input of the base, at the base terminal, that is at the input of the transistor, how far that signal is altering in the positive and in the negative direction. Large AC base voltages produces large variations, whereas small AC base voltages produces small variations. Now let us see what happens when, if this variation is having some problem with the swing. That means if it is not a small signal, if the variation is large, then what will happen? Is there any problem? If the question is there any problem if the variation is large? the AC voltage on the base produces an AC emitter current, and the AC emitter current has the same frequency as the AC base voltage. So how the emitter current will look like? If we extend the lines, that means if we extrapolate these lines horizontally, now vertically along the direction of voltage axis, we should be getting alternating voltage of VB. And if we extrapolate the lines towards the current axis, we will be getting an alternating voltage in terms of current. So this is the AC current representation of IE, that is emitter current, which is also alternating in nature. So we can see from here that for whole of the IV characteristics, the AC voltage and the AC current VB and IE will be constantly changing as per the applied alternating input signal at the base of the transistor. So you can see, if you compare these two, and also if you are having the input signal with you also, the frequency of that input signal will be matching up with the frequency of these signals. So the AC emitter current also has approximately the same shape as the AC base voltage. You can see from the two waveforms, if the AC base voltage is sinusoidal, emitter current is approximately sinusoidal. The AC, there will be a little bit difference. The two signals will not be an exact replica or perfect replica because of the curvature of the graph. So it may so happen that the spacing between these two points and these two points in the vertical direction will give such a curvature that may not match the curvature at the when it is extending the lines from the towards the horizontal direction. So the two waveforms may not be the exact replica of each other, and since the graph is curved upward, if this graph, suppose it is far more sharp to go towards the upward direction, then the positive half cycle of AC emitter current will be stretched. That means if suppose it goes further sharper, that means this the point QH will be in such a location that if we extend from there towards the current axis, the extrapolation will give you a much larger swing of the positive half cycle than the negative half cycle for the emitter current. So we can say in that case the swing for the positive half cycle is not matched with the swing of the negative half cycle for the same signal. So in for that case, we can say the distortion has occurred in the alternating cycles. That means distortion has occurred in the waveform of the emitter current, where the positive half cycle and negative half cycle may not match in terms of their swing. And it is undesirable for high fidelity amplifiers, because high fidelity amplifier means it should be highly efficient to produce the output. It is based on any input. So for high fidelity applications, these distortions are completely undesirable. So what is distortion? Distortion is disturbance in the signal, or unwantedness in the signal, or undesirableness in the signal. That is called distortion, which is disturbing the normal course of alteration of a signal. That is called distortion. So this is called distortion. So if we now want to reduce the distortion, there is a way based on this figure we can analyze that, is by keeping the AC base voltage small. So if we keep this input base voltage small, and because of that the IE will once again be restricted within such a limit that its swing, the swing for IE, may not be large enough, because as we are keeping VB to be swinging small in the positive and negative direction. So if you reduce the peak value of the base voltage, you reduce the movement of the instantaneous operating point in terms of the, because peak value Less means the Q point will move towards the upward side or downward side at lesser extent. So there will be small swing in terms of the VB at the input side. Now, the smaller the swing or variation, the less is the curvature of the graph. So the graph will quite become more flatter than the than being sharper because of small variation in the input signal. So we can say that if the signal is small enough, the graph appears to be linear. So this graph, which is helpful for our analysis purpose and calculation purpose, if it is linear, it can only happen so when the input signal is considered to be a small signal. So a small signal will mean a flatter IV characteristics, which is better for our analysis and mathematical purpose. So we can say that because there is negligible distortion for a small signal, when the signal is small, the changes in AC emitter current are almost directly proportional to the changes in AC base voltage if the signal is small, because the because the distortion will be lesser and these two waveforms will be almost a close replica of each other. So what we are saying that the changes in AC emitter current are almost, that is in the output, are almost directly proportional to the changes in AC base voltage, that is the input voltage, that means this one, and which is the AC input voltage is almost like a sine wave. So the AC emitter current will also be a sine wave with no appreciable changes or stretching. That means one half cycle is more having more swing than the other will not occur. Now there is a rule for which we can say that if the amplifier satisfies this rule, that means if the design of the amplifier is based on that rule, we can say that they are small signal amplifiers and the signals will be considered as small signals which will be handled by those amplifiers. So, and this rule is called 10% rule. The total emitter current, which has been drawn by me over here, consists of a DC component and AC component. So I am just explaining now what is 10% rule. So let this emitter current be having two parts, distributed in two parts, i.e. this is the emitter current, this is IEQ. IEQ is nothing but the DC part, and IE is the total emitter current, and plus small IE. I have already told you that all capital means it is DC and all small means it is AC. So this is the AC part of the emitter current. So now to minimize the distortion, if you want to minimize the distortion, that means unevenness between the amplitude swings of the half cycles, between the half cycles, the peak to peak value of this AC part, that is small IE, must be small compared to IEQ. The peak to peak value, that means the amplitude changes of IE, should be much smaller than the amplitude of the DC part, that is IEQ. So hence we can say the original Q point will be very much fixed at a particular location, and the position of the, or the location of the Q point just above or below that original position will not be very much extended. So we can say that for small signal operation, the condition is IE, small IE, that is AC part of emitter current, and its peak to peak value PP is, should be less than 0.1 IEQ. This is called 10% rule. This means the AC signal, that means the AC part of the emitter current, is small, will be called a small signal when the peak to peak AC emitter current is less than 10% of the DC emitter current. So that's why it is called 10% rule. That means the AC part of the emitter current will be less than 0.1, means 10% of the value of the amplitude of DC emitter current. If it satisfies, if this rule is satisfied by this, by the transistor amplifier which is handling such type of signal, then we can say that the particular type of amplifier will call small signal amplifier, which will satisfy this 10% rule. So small signal amplifiers are those which will be processing or amplifying the emitter current at its output, which is having a small peak to peak alternating range or alternating swing change, that should be less than 10% of the DC value of the same emitter current. Now this type of amplifier, this type of small signal amplifiers which will satisfy this 10% rule, generally seem to be used at the front end of radio and television receiver. So radio and TV receiver, that means in RF applications, radio and TV receivers at the front end. Front end means it in the in their power supply section, power supply unit. There we can observe the small signal amplifiers, and because the signal coming in from the outside via the antenna generally very weak, and that signal should be well amplified before going into the further processing part. So that signal which is coming from the outside being very weak is amplified by such amplifiers which are called small signal amplifiers. Now when coupled into a transistor amplifier, the signals getting from the outside via an antenna, a weak signal produces very small variation in emitter current, which must be less than 10% rule, which is much less than the 10% rule requires. So we need small signal amplification for those signals. Now let us move on to our next topic, AC beta. You know what is beta? It is the current gain, DC current gain of transistor amplifier, and it is the ratio of collector current and base current in common emitter mode. But till today, you know what is DC current gain actually, that is beta DC, which is IC by IB, you know till today. But the currents in this formula are the currents at the Q point based on the DC values. And because of the curvature of the characteristics, the DC current gain depends on the location of the Q point primarily. Now what is AC current gain? Let us see what is AC current gain, or which is defined as beta or sometimes as beta AC also, or alternately you can write only beta, which will mean that it is AC beta. It is small IC by small IB, and small means obviously it is the ratio of AC current, AC collector current and AC component of base current. So the AC signal, if we now draw the particular characteristic curve between IC and IB, if this is IB and this is IC, plot over here, and the variation is something like this, the curvature is something like this, where Q is here, QH is here and QL is here, the Q point is moved all along, and if we extend the lines in both the directions of the axis, something like this, then this will be the AC alternating waveform for IC, and this will be the alternating waveform for IB. So you can see that the IB and IC is of alternating nature. That means the alteration has started. That means we can now specify the beta in terms of AC value. So the AC signal uses only a small part of the graph on both sides of the Q point, and because of this, the value of AC current gain is different from the DC current gain. Okay, because the variation in the values of capital IC and capital IB along with small IC and small IB will be different. So as a result, the beta DC and beta AC will be having with different values. And the graphically beta AC is based on this graph is equal to the slope of the curve at the Q point. If we need to bias the transistor to a different Q point, the slope of the curve would change accordingly. That means beta AC would change. So that means if we want to change the Q point, that means we are immediately changing the value of the beta AC. So for a particular Q point, we are having a particular value of beta, and that is beta DC. But if my Q point is changing, that means beta DC is always constant, but beta AC may vary, and that variation of beta AC will be dependent on the new location of the Q point. That means its variation will change according to the variation of the Q point. So if in other words, the value of beta depends on the amount of DC collector current. Now, but the beta DC and beta AC values are comparable in nature. So for any particular problem, you can assume any of the two values, either DC or AC, and the variation of beta AC is because of the different slope of the characteristic curve. Because if Q point varies, if this is the new position of the Q point or this is the new position of the Q point, you can easily understand that at every position of Q point, the slope on this characteristic curve is changing. So based on the new position of the Q point, beta AC will also change. So this is AC beta. Now we will move on to the next topic, AC resistance of emitter diode. AC resistance of emitter diode. Once again, draw the same diagram, VBE and IE, and this is the characteristic curve. Extend the points, the different location of Q points. This is for IE and this is for VBE. Okay, so this is the graph once again, the same you have observed in the previous topic. Now, when a small AC voltage is applied across the emitter diode, a small AC voltage, it produces an AC emitter current. You can obviously understand. Now, the size of this AC emitter current depends on the location of the Q point, because it will depend on the size of the, that means size means the swing of the half cycles of a particular AC waveform will depend on the curvature of this IV characteristic. So that means the location of the Q point will vary, and accordingly you can get, so this is original Q, this is QH, and this is QL. So location of the Q point may vary on this curve, and based on the curvature we can get the different voltage and current values. So now because of the curvature, we get more peak to peak AC emitter current when the Q point is higher up the graph. That means we can say that as we go on high towards the upper side of the characteristic curve, that means the slope will become steeper. So we should be getting higher peak to peak value as we go on upward all along this characteristic curve. Now, as already I have written the equation that total emitter current has a DC component and an AC component. So IE is equal to IEQ plus small IE, where this is the DC part and this is the AC part of the emitter current IE. So now, in the similar way, the total base emitter voltage of this particular diagram or characteristic curve has a DC component and an AC component, and its equation can be written as VBE is equal to VBEQ plus small VBE. So similarly, as for this IE, we can write same thing for VBE if an alternating voltage is superimposed on the Q point value or quiescent value of the or the DC value of VBE. And for both this DC and AC will combine to give you the total voltage VBE. This is total value. So now in this in the given figure, the sinusoidal variation in VBE produces a sinusoidal variation in IE, because this one in the at the input will give you this at the output. So both are sinusoidal in nature. So the peak to peak value of IE, that is small IE, depends on the location of the Q point, and because of the curvature in the graph, a fixed VBE, that is small VBE, produces more IE, that means small IE, as the Q point is biased higher up end of the curve. That means for steeper slope, as you go up from the original Q point to the new position of the Q point, which is at a location much steeper than the previous, than the original, then you can get the new Q point will be lying at a higher curvature of the characteristic curve, and hence the peak to peak value of this current IE will be depending on the location of the new location of the Q point. And because of that steep curvature, a fixed VBE, if VBE is still same, it will produce the change in VBE, it will produce for a fixed VBE, it will produce more IE. That means the alternating emitter current as Q point is moved up, higher up. That means if we make this waveform as constant or fixed for this IE, if this current is to be more, that means if it is such that the slope is further steeper, then you can see that this Q will now come at here. So that means the peak to peak value for this characteristic curve will become, previously IE was like little bit flatter, now it will become more sharper. So peak to peak swing will be increased. So in other words, we can say the AC resistance of the emitter diode decreases when the DC emitter current increases. So we can say, I repeat, the AC resistance, that since the emitter current is increasing, that is the flat emitter current will now become more steep emitter current. Now since this emitter current IE, small IE, AC emitter current, alternating part of emitter current is increasing, that means the AC resistance of the emitter is decreasing. AC emitter current increasing means AC emitter resistance is decreasing than when the DC emitter current increases. I once again repeat, that means when this AC component is increasing, that means as a whole this IE is getting increased, that means the DC component, that means the DC emitter current, this one, which is having a fixed value, which is IEQ, but actually the total value DC was originally IEQ, and which is called the DC emitter current. Now when this AC emitter current is superimposed on this, that means this IE is superimposed on this fixed value, we are getting a new alteration on the DC emitter current IE. Now because of this increase of the DC emitter current, we can say that means if this IE is now having this characteristic like this, looking like this, then we can say if current increases, you know the resistance is decreased, so the AC resistance of the emitter diode decreases. Now this IE means it is the emitter current flowing through the emitter terminal, base emitter terminal, that is it is leaving from the base and going inside the emitter terminal, and then it will flow through the resistance RE into the ground. So this is the current which is flowing through the base emitter terminal. So we can say that the DC emitter current will increase as the AC resistance is decreased. So this is the AC resistance, RE, denoted by AC resistance decreases. Why? Because IE, AC emitter current, AC emitter resistance obviously decreases as AC emitter current increases. Okay, and as a result, for IE, total IE, that is I capital E, this will also increase, which is called DC emitter current. DC emitter current. So the AC resistance of emitter diode, the formula is given by RE dash. This is the AC resistance of emitter diode. Its formula is small VBE by small IE. This is RE dash. So please remember this formula to solve the numerical problems. VBE, small VBE by small IE, where small VBE is this one and small IE is this one. The ratio of base emitter voltage and the AC component of base emitter voltage and AC component of emitter current. That is the AC resistance of the emitter diode, denoted by RE dash. So we can say that the AC resistance of emitter diode equals the AC base emitter voltage divided by AC emitter current. The dash or the prime in the notation here is a standard way to indicate that the resistance is inside the transistor. That means it is not actually observed like an external resistance. It is, this resistance is inside the transistor. That means it is a logical or a virtual conception. Now let us see how to calculate this RE dash. Suppose we are having base emitter voltage 5 millivolt peak to peak. Suppose we are having a value 5 millivolt peak to peak, and suppose an AC emitter current 100 microampere is given. It is also peak to peak value. Then the AC resistance is 50 ohm. For another example, assuming a higher Q point, if VB is suppose given as 5 millivolt and IE as 200 microampere, then AC emitter resistance RE dash is 25 ohm. So we can say that the AC emitter resistance always decreases when the DC emitter current increases. That means DC emitter current increases means if this IE is increased, then this IE will also be increased, and as a result RE dash will decrease. And because this VBE will be essentially a constant value, this is for silicon, you know, it is 0.7 volt. So this VBE will not be giving you any appreciable change in the operation of the transistor. So the value of the increase or decrease of RE dash will essentially depend upon the increase or decrease of the parameter IE, because IE will in turn depend upon the parameter, its AC component small IE. The most useful formula to find AC emitter resistance, the most useful formula deriving with some physics and calculus, it is RE dashed equal to 25 millivolt, considering different values of different useful parameters, by capital IE. So this is the much more celebrated and famous formula to calculate the AC emitter resistance. It says that the AC resistance of emitter diode equals 25 millivolt divided by DC emitter current. This is DC emitter current. So you better remember this formula for different calculations. So this is a very important formula. and this formula is quite widely used for all applications, especially for small signal operation of transistor amplifier at room temperature, and also for abrupt rectangular base emitter junction. And this formula is widely used for industry by the industry persons to calculate this AC emitter resistance. But in practice, in some practical commercial transistors, this formula will be a little bit different, and it may vary from 25 millivolt by IE to 50 millivolt by IE for commercial transistor for different other commercial types. So in that case, this will be little bit differed. And also another thing to before I conclude, another important thing is, what is the significance of this AC emitter resistance? The significance is, it is important to study the AC emitter resistance because it determines the voltage gain determination. And how that is possible? Less is the value, smaller is the value of IE, the higher is the voltage gain. The smaller value of RE dashed means higher voltage gain, and this will be established late in one of my later lectures. How this is possible, that smaller value of RE dashed is higher voltage gain, we will see later. But for the time being, the physical significance or importance of studying this AC emitter resistance and this formula is because, by this, if we made this resistance smaller, if we keep this resistance at a smaller value, that means we should be getting high voltage gain from the transistor amplifier.